Hi, my name is Stephanie Gill, and I'm the Supervisor for Science and Technology Engineering 6th through 12th grade. Today we're going to be talking about our new curriculum at the middle school called OpenSciEd. This is a curriculum that goes 6th through 8th grade. This is a presentation about the curriculum that we shared with the Whitcomb PTO in the fall, and there'll be some footage of that later on. So OpenSciEd is a middle school applied science curriculum. It's phenomenon-based, it's based on the next generation science standards, and several nonprofit organizations help to develop the curriculum. The idea is that we have high-quality curriculum that's freely available and comes with fantastic science materials. So the goal of this was to ensure that all educators from elementary to high school have access to coherent, rigorous, research-based materials and framework for science. In each grade level, there are 6 units total that make up the curriculum, and the sequence of lessons is actually driven by student questions after they interact with the phenomenon. Also included in the curriculum are great routines and practices that support the students to develop really awesome questions and investigate their own questions. Lastly, teachers get a plethora of support materials, Google Drive materials, videos, worksheets. Everything is included in this curriculum. So this drawing is what I love about OpenSciEd. In general, traditional science curriculum is very teacher-based. Teachers present information, then they have students do activities that sort of prove that the teacher was right, and then they take an assessment where they just spit back the things that they learned from the teacher. In OpenSciEd, the reason this is drawn as a curve is because this starts with a phenomenon. So the kids either experience a phenomenon or they watch a video that includes a phenomenon, and then they begin to make their own questions about the phenomenon. They draw models to guess how things are working. And then as they progress through the unit, they do small investigations where they discover, was what I thought right, or do I need to change my thoughts? A lot of times during the lesson, students have time to come back together and have class discussions. They have discussions with partners. They design their own investigations, but they build and build on their knowledge. They draw more models. And finally, towards the end, they piece together all of the different things that they have investigated and discovered. And they answer big questions. And these units are specifically designed to hit the Massachusetts frameworks, and they do a really good job. They're long units, but they hit many, many standards. So for this activity with the PTO, I had them do explore a phenomenon. And this phenomenon was from the weather unit. And this is just an example. So you can see there's video clips that the teacher shows, and there's a notebook page that the students fill out with notice and wonders. So this would be the very first thing that students would do. They would watch these videos, and they would look for things that they notice, which is an observation. And then they would change those observations into questions, which is a wonder. So I showed these videos. They happened to be about hailstorms because this is the weather unit. And parents got a little experience in noticing and wondering. This is an example of a driving question board that 8th grade students developed after watching these videos. So they watched these videos about hailstorms. And then as you can see, they put all sorts of questions on the board. And then they even organized the questions into areas. That's what the orange stickies are. So this is a driving question board. And throughout the unit, the teacher is going to refer back to this. And they're possibly going to do actual investigations that look at their own questions. The next thing, somewhere in the middle of the unit, this is an investigation that the students did that I had the parents do at the PTO. So, and this is about making predictions. So they have a bottle there, as you can see, and it gets a soap bubble over the top of it so that it holds the air that's in the bottle. And then they put the bottle in cold water and they put it in hot water and they see what happens to the air inside of the bottle. And the way they see the air inside the bottle is they see how the soap bubble reacts. So the parents got to experience this. They made predictions and then they actually did the investigation. And from this, the students would then take this information and make models and change up their ideas, their original ideas from the phenomenon. So this is the testing. This is, again, showing they use a lot of notebooks in here, and they write a lot about their thoughts. They draw a lot about their thoughts. So I didn't have the parents do this, but this is something that the students would definitely do. And then they would also draw a model. So I talked about after the phenomenon, they make all these driving questions and they develop an initial model. Then as they learn more about the phenomenon, they start drawing models that have more meaning to them because they've learned pieces of the puzzle. So that was the presentation that I shared with the PTO back in October. We are currently implementing OpenSciEd at 6th grade, 7th grade, and 8th grade, and all of our teachers are teaching the lessons. Before this year, we actually were in the state-run pilot for OpenSciEd curriculum, and we had several teachers at each grade that piloted many of the units, and they shared their feedback with the developers, and changes were made to the curriculum. So the other wonderful thing about this is that a lot of teachers in the state of Massachusetts got to share what they liked and what they didn't like about the lessons that were developed, and the developers took that feedback and made some really great changes to the unit. The weather unit was one that was changed quite a bit. So currently, not to mention, are we implementing the curriculum because it's been released, it's not in pilot form anymore, but we are part of a grant to develop a cohort across the state, and all of the other middle schools in the state that are implementing OpenSciEd are part of this grant as well. The grant pays for the non-consumable materials that we use, because a lot of these units will have something like a glass bowl, or those 2-liter soda bottles that you saw. Those are things we can use again and again. This grant is good for 3 years, and slowly we'll be implementing. As I said, there were 6 units, so we're implementing 4 of them this year. We'll probably put in the 5th one next year, and then the 3rd year of the grant, we'll be running all 6 units. So you might wonder, like, why aren't we running the entire curriculum, you know, this first year? This is a really big change in the pedagogy, or how teachers teach kids. And so the teachers are trying very hard to do it with fidelity and to do it well. And to do that, it would be very difficult to ask teachers in the first year to do all 6 units. So they're really concentrating on the 4 units this year, and then we'll keep going forward. Some of the teachers have had some amazing success with some of the things their students have done in their classrooms. For example, the 6th grade teacher, Carey Doucette, her students submitted work for STEM Week through the 1-8 Foundation and the STEM Hub, who are also participate in the development of OpenSciEd. And they were chosen by industry experts as a great example of an initial model from a phenomenon. Thank you so much for watching this video and learning about OpenSciEd. We're so excited to be implementing this curriculum this year at Whitcomb. If you'd like to know more, in the description of this video are links as well as my email address. Feel free to reach out. I'd love to talk to you about OpenSciEd.